Hello students, you're welcome on Learning with L&R, and today I would like to talk with you regarding the teaching and learning process. First of all, we have to discuss about the definitions of teaching and learning. First of all, the teaching. Teaching is an active process in which one person shares information with others to provide them with the information to make behavioral changes. Or the person who provides the information to the others, that person should be competent or expert in that particular area. Okay, for example, we are belong to nursing profession, and the nursing personnel or nursing teachers who teach the students expert or specialized in their particular specialty. Then learning is the process of assimilating information with the resultant change in behavior. Okay, the students gain the information from the teacher, and that particular information changes their behavior with knowledge. Then teaching learning process is a planned interaction that promotes behavioral change that is not a result of maturation and coincidence. Okay, the teaching learning process, in this the teacher provides the knowledge to the learner or to the students. As a result, the behavior of the students ultimately change with knowledge. After that, the elements of teaching and learning. First of all, the teacher. The first element is teacher. The teacher is considered as the element that has the main role in the teaching learning process, because he is the one who provides the information to the students. He or she is considered as the so-called prime mover of the educational processes. Thus, he or she directs the flow of the whole process and serves as main control of the teaching learning process. The next one is the teacher is the one that facilitates the whole process of learning. In the teaching learning process, the teacher is the main who provide the facility, who provide the knowledge to the students. Then the next one is learners or students. The learners are considered as the key participant in the teaching and learning process. They are considered as the primary subject or the main reason why the process is implemented. Process is only for the students who want to learn about the new things. The knowledge that acquired by the learners will decide whether the teaching and learning objectives are achieved. If the learner learn lots of things from the teaching, it means the teaching learning process is going on progressive pathway or achieved the main objective. What is the objective? The teachers have the objective to teach the students, and at the end, the learner learn from that particular information. The third element is milieu. It means the environment, the learning environment. The learning environment is the main or the key aspect in the elements of teaching and learning. Since the learning is triggered off by stimuli in the environment, it assumes primary importance in teaching and learning. Or the next one is the classroom is the usual, although not the exclusive environment of learning at school. Teachers need to make the learning environment as stimulating as possible. The conducive environment must be there so that the students can learn more and more information in that particular environment. Okay, then the next one is every stimulus in the classroom should contribute to learning. In the classroom, there might be some models like if someone, the teacher teach about the anatomy, then there is a model of that particular system, particular organ, or there is some charts or the other aviates are there to learn, so that the students can learn more. Then the next one is very much part of this environment is the human stimuli, the most important of whom is the teacher himself. Teacher have lots of knowledge, and he equipped with loaded of knowledge with him. Material stimuli includes object in the room as well as common routine activities. Then the next one is matter, the content of learning which the teacher teach to the students. This refers to what is to be learned by specified in the instructional objective. Then the next one is the teacher should make sure that the minimum standard or level of proficiency is attained by the class before moving on the next lesson or unit. Okay, the students have the each and every point clear before the lecture. Curriculum makers are advised to be realistic in projecting subject matter and avoid giving the students too much too soon, and to teach only little matter but well mastered. Okay, the curriculum should be planned accordingly with the need of the society. Okay, then the next one is method, the teaching learning strategy. This consists of purposeful planned activities and tasks that are undertaken by the teacher and the students in the classroom to bring about the intended instructional objectives. Then the next one is the learners must also show efficiency in handling the activity, going through it without hassle. The next one, the strategy must also be effective to yield expected result and must be economical in time, effort and expense. The teacher, the method which used by the teacher should be very familiar for the teacher, or the teacher should be master on that particular strategy. Okay, then the next one is material, the resources of learning. Materials are resources available to the teacher and learners which serve as stimuli in the teaching learning situation. This may be either as human person or a physical object. The whole purpose of materials is to initiate the students to the real world they live in. Okay, the next one, instructional materials represents elements found in that world are meant to help students understand and explain the reality. Portraying reality can be by direct experience, reproduction and representation or abstraction. The resource of the learning or the material of the learning, the teacher have to familiar with or master on that particular material. Then the next one is media, communication in teaching and learning. This pertains to the communication system in the teaching learning situation. This serves dual purpose, to promote common understanding in instructions and to set and maintain a healthy psychological climate in the classroom conducive to learning. And the communication is very much important in teaching and learning process. If the teacher know about how to communicate the thing, how to communicate the matter or content with the students, then it is very feasible for the students to gain the knowledge. Then the next one, motivation, arousing means curiosity and sustaining interest in learning. Motivation is the cardinal principle in learning, means the teacher have the capacity to motivate the students to learn about the new things. A learner will learn only those things he wants to learn, in which the learner interested in. Okay, then mastery, the be all and end all of learning. This means internationalization of learning resulting in automatic or habitual change behavior through meaningful repetition and application. For example, from the first year to fourth year, in the first year we teach or demonstrate the procedures to the students regarding how to provide care to the patients, and till the fourth year the students know how to take care or handle the patient independently at the time of emergency also. Then mastery comes through a fixation of what is to be learned, shifting it from short term to long term memory, allowing for ease in use and transfer to new situations in the future. Some call it executive control. Okay, fixation is all these things which we discussed. Then psychological security, for learning to take place, participation of learner is essential. If the participant or the learner is not there, then teaching learning process is not achieved. Then the learner would not participate freely unless he feels secured. The teacher can't teach the child by threats. The learner must be given the stimulating environment. Only in this environment, the pupils are encouraged to try and therefore more likely to learn. Then the next one is feedback. A student learns more rapidly and more thoroughly because he is forced to concentrate on material before him and because he gets immediate feedback on his progress. So that if the teacher provide the feedback to the students after the test or after the class or after any answer, then the students encouraged or motivated to learn about the things. Then it is not uncommon that after solving a problem, the child is interested to know whether his solution is correct or not. If the teacher provides the information regarding their solution is right or their solution is wrong or there is some fixation, there is some need to improvement, then the students learn more. Then next is practice. Practice makes a man perfect. The proverb implies the importance of repetition in bridging certain habits up to the point where they come naturally to him. The factor of practice is particularly true of skill learning. Practice is must. When the teacher complete their part or perform their part very well, they introduce the content and explain each and everything about the content. If the students not practice that material or not practice that demonstration, then it is impossible for the students, for the learner to learn about the new thing. Then belonging and configuration. Repetition, practice or drill, whatever we may call it, will not result in learning. Only after restructuring, the learner can integrate and organize the experience in certain required relation. Thus, belonging and configuration makes the teaching learning process more effective. Then the next one is significance of teaching learning process in nursing. As a nurse, one of our principal responsibility is to educate our patients so that they can take care of themselves at the home after the discharge from the hospital. Our teaching reaches across a broad area such as medication, old and new medicine, procedures, wound care, signs and symptoms to be aware of, health habits, how to continue caring for themselves once they are at home. The teaching can occur as spontaneous answer to a question from a patient or nurse, formal education and resource material, right? Then the next one is patients are held in home for increasingly shorter stays and are going home sicker, precipitating a greater need for structured information than ever before. The information we provide them during their hospital stay will hopefully help them in gaining full recovery and decrease the risk of readmission. That's why there is a need for education to the patient so that they can independently take care of themselves after the hospital discharge. Thank you so much. I hope you have clear with this. Thank you for attention.